Oh, that's it. Big cheery wave. Come on, Val. Aberystwyth in central Wales. Lovely sunny place. Soft white sandy beaches. 5-star hotels everywhere. Enjoying the sun. Walking down to the promenade. God. It will snow any minute, I think.
This is liquid sunshine.
Oh my God. Lovely town. Yeah, the plain one should be fine. See where we go from here. Oh my God, it's
home to Bali, I hope. Oh shit, that's sleet. Oh, bitch, yeah.
Can you just make sure there's plenty of coffee in there? This is where I used to stay 40 years ago. A little different now though. There used to be railway lines down here. I used to put stones on the tracks and watch the trains crush them to powder. Rotten little shit of a kid. Beautiful. The Welsh have a great sense of humour. A little cold. And that's where we are.
Yeah, there you are. Good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Fine,
eh?
Good morning.
The old toll bridge. I used to fish for flathead. Then my dad would feed the fish I caught to the cat. The toll keeper. What about 5 feet?
I've got no money on me.
Won't you let us walk across?
Yeah.
Well, okay. We don't bother with them.
How long have you been the toll keeper here?
Well, I've been here 4 years.
All right, give it a bit of special effects now. Oh, you're steaming across the bends there. All right, head down to Burma. To the sea.
Oh, there's the ocean.
Yeah.
Not very far.
Oh no, very close. Barmouth's a big city too. Wonderful. Come on, we'll offer him 200,000 quid. You'd make a great barmaid.
Don't have the tits for it.
You do. We'll buy you a plunging dress. We'll show your neckline.
A plunging Diana Dawes jumper. Jeez, I tell you what, this truck's moving along this way.
Ooh, that's the George III. Yeah, fancy a nice gammon steak for breakfast with 2 poached eggs.
Fat Welsh sausages.
Hopefully you'll be able to see the snow.
I'm just stopping it.
Trying to find it.
Has it stopped focusing on it? There we are.
This is the slate mine at Blaena Festidiog. Some of the mountains where the slate is taken from.
The dam's like colder than it looks.
Ooh, it's freezing. Actually, the sun's out now. It's nice. Entrance, of course. Obviously, Port Merion, this is the entrance. We're just going to go inside and have a look at this place now. Actually, it's nice now the sun's out. Ready? For the pub. What's this? This is Cardigan Bay, isn't it?
Yep. Cardigan Bay minus the bay.
Well, it's the water.
Jesus, it goes a long way out.
Oh, I can't focus them. Like, they were having a good snog there. Peacock's noisy. Hope you soon have been impressed. Peacock we heard.
Mm?
I was just saying that's the peacock we heard.
I just put them in the wall.
This place is really quite weird. I think that guy lives there, sitting up on that balcony.
Yeah, it's really still too far.
Is this the pub, Mitch? Do you know?
Yeah, I hope so.
Alright. Oh, a couple of two. Got you first. This place is really quite weird.
Back
Okay, the last bit of Port Mahon. This is down on the foreshore on the beach. Wish that kid would shut up. Do you want kids, Mitch?
What do you think?
God, you've still got a good bum.
You should pack it in with a still.
I thought I'd take a view. Sorry, a shot of the view out of our window. Don't think we'll turn that.
No, we can camera. Put the other lens on.
It's lovely and warm at the moment, and rain and cold winds tomorrow. Shit. Just what I need, somebody to start that car when I start filming such a beautiful scene. And here we come to Carnarvon Castle. Very well preserved. In fact, she is very well preserved indeed. Here's another view of Carnarvon with all the traffic. And oh, who's that? I seem to recognise her. She's got a camera. Another view of Carnarvon Castle, and that is a Chinese floating restaurant. The Anglesey Hotel, we haven't tried that there yet, but we probably will. A door knocker.
How do I know? You should be filming that guy running, which is what you should be doing, not standing up there, playing peeping Tom.
I filmed the door knocker, that's the door it belongs to. Nice old door. The entrance to Carnarvon Town itself. With a lorry and the shop. Big castle though. Finally back at Beaumaris Castle. Just heard that they no longer have the tennis courts within the castle walls. They haven't had tennis courts in here for over 30 years, you reckon? Well, I used to play on them. April 17, 1992. Smile! Do you take the lens cap off?
Just hurry up, will you? Swaying up and down there like a bloody ship in the wind.
Wells Crafts is now a bloody great woolen shop. This is inside one of the turrets. Beautifully made castle. My God. That's where they used to look at people and pull their tongues out. The entrance. This is the entrance to the tennis court within Balmain's castle. No longer here. It was just there that they had two courts. What a great place to play tennis. Guaranteed never to lose your ball. Modern transport in Balmain. Smile. Ball.
Oh, that'll be guys with bad backs.
This Welsh town has the distinction of having the longest place name in the world. Probably one of the smallest towns, but certainly got the largest name. The tourist again. You just love being the tourist, don't you?
I really hate this. I'm just glad nobody will ever see me again. No one will know me.
This is a nice sunny ridge at the base of Snowdon in the national park. I'm presently wearing just a pair of thongs and a swimsuit. Really is quite warm today. The locals are complaining that it's a little bit too hot. Taking photographs of me in my swimwear.
To record.
This is Swallow Falls. Good testing territory around here. Take your bloody head out of the way. Here I am at the bottom of Swallow Falls, lifting life and then taking this breathtaking city off this huge waterfall. As Michelle said, it's not Niagara Falls, but it's not bad. Shopping on a Saturday in the Welsh town of Conway. The whole town seems to be encircled by an old medieval wall. I wanted to buy that house, but she said it was too big after she'd been in it. Here's the star of the movie The Plank. And there we have Conway Castle. Some park cars. Let's see. Waterfront of Conway. River Dee. Not what day it's on. Pretty enough, huh? And this is one of the Conway bridges. That's the other one behind it, and apparently there's another one behind that also. Another car. One of the original bridges, built in 1826, I think, but now closed. Bloody imposing castle, that's great. Yeah. We've just arrived into the city of Chester. These are some of the old buildings that we've got. That's a great old building. This is what, Bridge Street, isn't it? Yeah, I think so. This is now on the upper level. That's a beautiful old store.
Have a look inside there. We've got a bookland on the ground level. We've got one of the finest of these medieval crypts in Chester. They adapted it very carefully as a bookshop. But it's worth having a look at, as I say, if you're here tomorrow or the day after. Have a look in there. They let you browse around without knowing anything at all.
There's history everywhere in this town. Skip that, that's not good. There's that sexy lady again. That's Michelle after a hard night on the town. Oh no, sorry. No, that's Michelle after a hard night on the town. Looking at old, these old buildings has reminded Michelle that she must buy some anti-wrinkle cream.
There's a reflection in the glass.
That's a clock and the time's even right. This is looking from Eastgate. Barclays Bank, and Michelle's real pissed off with no Lloyds here. So there. Another looking old pub, but it's not old.
Do you know what? When I went there in the morning, like the following day.
Don't know what this is, but it's very pretty. This is probably Chester Cathedral, we think. Good examples of Georgian architecture. Canal boats on the canal. Fantastic. Probably thought it was going to get run over. What a peaceful way of going. Pretty noisy. The walls completely surround the town. Oh, there's Michelle playing with the dogs. Hello, man. Gary, give us a smile. Now, Michelle has just realised that this water goes downhill. Oh, shit. If you look carefully, that level of water there is lower from that level of water there. It's a lovely coloured stone, isn't it? This is where Michelle lost her shirt.
Chester Racecourse. Once a Roman harbour. Viking ships hoeing up the race course.
Raping and pillaging.
Raping and pillaging the horses.
Hey, look, Michelle, a Roman Billy Bartlin's holiday camp. There's a three-story Georgian tent for the Roman Emperor. This is apparently the only race course in the world where they run the races anti-clockwise. And it's the oldest race course in the British Isles. This is just very interesting. I don't know what it is. There's a bus just going past the weird weir. That's pretty basic stuff. There's that interesting thing again. That's a pub Michelle got thrown out of. The bull in the barman. Another pretty shot with the back of Michelle's head. It's a beautiful row of cars. Guess what that is? Put the two together, and what do you have? Michelle reliably informs me that that is the Roman amphitheatre in Chester. Must have been very noisy for the actors.
There's a little sign down there that says Chester Amphitheatre. Zoom in on it.
All right, I will. If you can read that, you've got better eyes than I've got.
No, the green one.
Oh, the wrong one, I'm sorry. That's the one I should have been for. Voila. This is the town hall of Chester. Well, where's Michelle? She's trying to find the toilet somewhere. All of these old black and white doors. I just think this is cute. Lovely old building. In fact, Chester's a lovely old town.
I think tomorrow night the pictures, yeah.
What was that? Doesn't hang around when she's taking a photograph, does she? Have you noticed this? She sizes it up, uses both eyes too. She always remembers to wind a film on. How is that, my dear?
Dreadful.
Oh, what's wrong?
It's not very good for their digestion, especially on camera. Pizza's lovely. I saw you sell it stinks. That's it, don't expect any more than I've got.
Part of the walls around York Minster. Oh, it's that looks so beautiful. Quite spot. Entrance to the old part of York, mostly leading up to York Minster. Oh, sorry about that. Here we have York Minster. It is a fantastic place. This is all the repair work. It really is falling down on the outside. This really is a super building. Absolutely magic. We're just about to go on a 1-hour guided tour of the inside. Then we'll know a little bit more about it. It's actually very humble, all this.
'1405 to '1408, it took 3 years to make this garcination. The contract for doing the window was given to a Coventry firm, John Thornton of Coventry. The contract is still in existence, and the payment for 3 years' work, including £10 for a bonus if they got it done in the time, was £58. That's 3 years' work. The whole window tells a story of the beginning of the world and the end of the world. If you ignore the tracery at the very top, and the rest of it, all the revelations, are so complicated that it's in the way that I can start. You know, they've got a whole list of just
different
chests. Both chests are so special.
So day and night, basically. And we're standing under a well, and the boy and the girl and the rabbit looking down. And that one is Neil Armstrong putting his father's bikes on the moon. And he started all off in 1220 and Neil Armstrong. The names of all the craftsmen who did the restoration are carved on the exit door. It's all our own work, apart from the plumbing firm that put the grate underneath. The tower, if you feel like...
There's Michelle going to buy a postcard for her mum. This is outside the West Wing. Another view of Yorkton Station. Really is quite superb. We came in towards the main tower, didn't we? Face on.
Yeah, but we're parked behind the cathedral.
These have got to be genuine, ye old English oak leaded window. Just to give you an idea of how much this stone has actually been eaten away by acid rain. Quite incredible. Very big pot plants coming out in chunks, and this is what you're trying to say. Well, here we are in Sherwood Forest, and this is a great landmark that we walked miles to come and see, and it's called the Major Oak. As you can see, it's fallen down. Weird looking thing. It must be very old. We'll find out very soon how old it is. But as you can see, it's Easter.
As you can hear,
it's Easter. Look at them all. Let's go and find out how old it is. Here we are in the town of Matlock in Derbyshire, and it is not 1712 and 49 seconds. It's actually in the morning about 10 o'clock. A lot of rush hour traffic behind us. What's that? What's that? Just left.
Nelson's Monument.
Just
this competitive pub where she's brought me a birthday drink.
Whoa!
What was that? There was nothing.
I know there was, and I just didn't piss you off.
Isn't she lovely? Come on, give me a kiss. Thanks, my dear.
Birthday kiss.
I have a master's degree in science.
Here we are in Brighton, of all places, and this is the famous Brighton Pavilion. It is a real grotty building. So out of keeping with the area. It's too much. This woman is intent on trying to commit suicide. See that she just stands in front of the car and blocks the road. Staring at the driver. Now back to the serious stuff of boring you to death with home movies of the Brighton Pavilion. Terrible thing. Here's another angle of this monstrosity.
Not as interesting as the woman in the road.
No, I think I'll go back and film more of that. Well, here we are on the foreshores of Brighton. It's lovely and warm. Probably a force for gale blight at the moment. Oh. Now this here is a famous pier. On the foreshore, that's Brighton there. Now this seems to be a bit of a problem. How do you get out to that pier? It doesn't seem to be anyway. Maybe you have to swim on it. Oh, focus. Sorry about it. Disappeared. How about that for a great competition, huh? Winkle picking. This is the entrance to the famous Brighton Pier. Another shot of the pier here. This is a bit more sheltered, but it's nice. This I find amazing. All that wrought iron all the way down there. Who's that? You recognise that? There we are, there's a bit of detail about what these arches are really like. I'm sure you're really interested. This must be one of the hell of a boring tape.
Maybe it is.
On the waterfront in Brighton seems to be very, very cheap. That glassed-in apartment there for sale, they want £75,000. So they're pretty big inside. And this is how close you are to the beach in the marina. Oh, well, on the other side of that wall is the marina. It really is a beautiful place.